Hello everybody, I'm Andy Phillips and this is Iron Concepts number 58. So, I haven't figured out exactly the best method, or at least a good rock solid method, for approaching the design of large pieces when those large pieces are assembled. I have many opinions in this area, and I feel that there's a good solid argument to be made as to why this method is one of the great basics. I just haven't grasped that argument yet. And really, there are a lot of interchangeable parts to this sort of superbly adaptable solution that can be applied to so many different problems. And that's with all of the important parts that go into a complex design in iron. The overall design, the gesture of its form, both on a small scale and on a grand scale. Then there are the focal points of your form and the textures of the individual elements themselves. You've got a lot to think about, and even after you follow all that through, really, you have all the problems that come from taking a lot of small elements and joining them all together to make one bigger thing. It's a lot to put into one bucket. But that's something I just want to kind of keep in the back of my mind, because what I really want to look at today are the joints that are formed when you start putting all of those elements together. Because practically speaking, in our trade, if you're going to make anything of much scale and you don't want to work with huge pieces of iron, then you're going to have to make a lot of smaller pieces and put them together. And all those pieces, they don't just magically snap together. They have to be joined somehow. And all those joints add up and they start to become a big part of the overall design. But here's one of the great superpowers of our trade that's sort of fueled by iron. If you really think about it, no matter how small your forge is, no matter how small that your operation is, if you can make something about the size of an S-hook, you can take pieces that you forged, say bars or scrolls or even rings that are the same size as that S-hook, and if you have the ability to cold rivet things together, then you really can build some pretty massive work. And you're only limited by your imagination and your engineering skill to keep it from sort of collapsing in on itself. But the engineering is one thing. I don't really want to focus on that today. Not so much as to how strong you can make those joints, rather what to do with them all. You see, it's often the case in many different materials, not just ours, that the first instinct of the craftsman when he has to put two pieces of metal together, when he has to join two pieces of material together, is to hide that seam and hide the joint. And of course, we all want to build, especially from the beginning, we all want to build huge, seamless works of art that show the power and capability that we have in our craft. It seems such a natural first decision to make. We want to weld the joint and then grind it flush, or forge weld it and then file away the evidence of that forge weld, or even fit a blind rivet so tight that once you paint over it, it just disappears. But then when you step back and look at it, really, who are you fooling? And more importantly, what do you actually gain by going to these extents? In our trade, it's superbly important. Now, actually, I think more than ever to be honest to the material itself and honest to the process. And this takes practice. There is beauty in telling the truth about the way that a piece came together. You should be celebrating the places where you forged elements and had to join them together, not hiding it. But to do that, this means that your rivets need to be bold. And your forged welds, well, they can show. And following this same argument, even your MIG welds can shine. And that's a subject I think I should maybe just touch on for today, because we could probably stick on that for a while. But think about it this way. If you're going to grind in all of your MIG welds because they're a distraction to the flow of your work, then think about this. Maybe your design needs to change to be more in tune with your process, rather than hiding your process to hold up your design. But that's about it for me today. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the drawing. If you're watching this on the Big Blue channel, we're changing everything over to the Iron Concepts channel. So make sure to hop over there and subscribe, because eventually we're going to remove everything from this channel. There is, of course, a link in the description below. If you have any other thoughts on this, feel free to comment. And if there are any topics you want to delve into in the future, my email is also in the description below. So thank you for watching, and until next time, thanks and bye.